could just speak. I'm usually working, selling stuff, something, or helping somebody with something. But this is a little different. No, this is a lot different from stepping on things. So, you know, a lot of things, our experiences build us up to what we're becoming, where we're going. So it's always a good thing. All right, so of course my love over here, she knows me as your baker, but it's actually a couple other things I have been working on. I do have my own baking business. Got my LLC in 2017, but then just recently I got another LLC. So it's called Divine's Magic. So with Divine's Magic, it's more so I'm doing events like this, where I'll actually be able to come out and talk, do things where painting with a twist. I'll actually be selling other products, like shea butters, oils, I do barbecue sauces, syrups. It's a lot of things that I like to do. And, oh, paint too. So, and I had to share this with you too. And because if it wasn't for you, when I first met you, it was at the great, the creative mind, and we were talking, and I was just like, yeah, I like to draw stuff, but I just like to keep it in my book. And she was just like, well, why don't you try to paint? And I was there, I said, paint, what? And I was like, that's totally outside my comfort zone. I was just like, I don't know. She was just like, you should try it. So, this summer I actually did try it. I'm learning that I can convert whatever I sketch in beautiful, I can do it on the canvas now. Yeah. So thank you, because that was a big encouragement. So I appreciate you.
Thank you.
Yeah. I do have some paintings. I did bring with me. I'll just bring them out after I speak.
What are you doing?
I don't know. All right, so I'm still in this shy phase. I got it. Believe it or not, I don't talk to people like this. So y'all just talk. Sometimes you be in a question, you're like, no, I gotta get this right. So I do anxiety and that. But I'll move on. Now, the original title was Innocence Stolen from a Child, but then I was speaking with somebody, had somebody else look at it, and they said I should probably do Stolen Innocence instead. So I'm renaming it called Stolen Innocence, written back April 25th, 2006. It can be taken away without one knowing or realizing. Unfair to the next generation that comes along. It's a shame that we will never feel the joy that you once felt. Sadness, pain, rage is all we see. But you were a child once. At one point in time, you had joy. Photos are the only thing that we can see where your true happiness was at once. Once your innocence was taken, all of the beautiful things have gone away. Slowly but surely, you're losing loved ones because everybody else in your mind is wrong and you're right. At one time, you were young too, but you seem to forget. And now our childhood is lost and has been stolen too. This forces us to play the adult roles we shouldn't have to. This causes bitterness and shame for us to think very little of you. Still continue to love you the same and unconditionally. So with that poem, I wrote that, I think I was kind of like reflecting when I was staying with my grandma because the situation occurred where some unnecessary stress came along. Parents called me for money. I just graduated from college. I ain't got no job or nothing. And I was, again, trying to figure out, how am I going to get this money for these adults? But they're my parents. So I just got out of my bag and I had to go let my grandma see and she said she enjoyed it. So, but yeah.
Thank you. I got a question. Do you still write now? Or was that something you did like first out of college? Like, you still writing poetry?
It's like very, actually, I do. It's just that, I don't know. I gotta start putting it out there. I don't know, with my work, it was always, you know how everybody say I'm an artist and I'm sensitive about my, and it's true, but when you growing up, and I want to speak to a couple of points, as far as especially when you were up there. I feel like in the Black family, the household, a lot of things, they don't feel as though it's important, but those little intricate things are very important. It can be detrimental and cause long-term trauma. And then the other issue I had with Black families also, or it could be other families, but this is just what I'm seeing and people in my era and the age range, the family secret. The family secret is what really like tears everybody apart. Because I've been violated too. Oh, I've been violated too. And the same person, still allowed to be around kids, and everything else, and everybody, like you said, it makes it seem like you're crazy, but you know something happened to you. You know something happened to you. There's a reason why you feel the way you feel and how you deal with the things.
And you're not the only person that knows. You're just the only person that acknowledges.
Exactly.
It's always something. It's always easier to blame the victim than it is to accept responsibility and put the blame on the right person and actually give them a punishment. People don't want to feel like it's taken away from the family or whatever, or like you ratting or something like that. It's just all these crazy like stigmas put onto a lot of different things that we can't really control. Mm-hmm. Thank you for sharing that.
No, no problem. Thank you.
I just wanted to speak on something you said. You said your age range. Honestly, it's not. This has been going on for hundreds of years. We were systematically pulled apart as families and youths. And it's not something that, so we see it as something that we should hide and be ashamed of and be afraid of. But it's actually something that we need to embrace. And until we do, we're going to continue the cycle. Because we have to acknowledge the fact that we are broken as families and as people. And the acknowledgement is the first step. And then the second step, and then the third step, and the fourth step, and until we take that first step, we can't. And so I don't think that it's right for us, or good for us, or productive for us to feel bad.
things that you said just made me think about a generally bigger pictures than just like physical abuse, but just like slavery in general. Like, we are not that. That's not the only thing that has happened to us. And a lot of classes and people teach us that that's where our history started. That is not where our history started. We were long before coming to America. You feel me? We were African people. We were living lives without white people and prospering in that way, and that's what they don't teach us, that we were great before that. If your history starts with slavery, that's all. Everything you do after that is like, cool, great, but it's not. It's not like it starts us out at a negative 10, where white people start out with a 0, or maybe even a 10 because they got privilege. And it's just like, and we aren't just that, but that right there that is still happening to us today, it still prevents us from being able to do a lot, and I think it contributes. It contributes mad to our mental illness or mental health issues, and I think that unity is like a really good way to break free. That's why I appreciate events like this.
So yes, thank you. That's really the point of this event, is to not only bring us together as a community, because we all have something to bring to the table, but to also allow for the space to be set. Like, taboo is the name of it because we don't talk about it. We don't talk about what's going on in our talk about what's going on in our lives, depression and anxiety are white people problems, you know, black people don't deal with this, you just gotta be stronger, get stronger, pull yourself up by your bootstraps, like, you can have the same thing that they have, and no, like, you're fighting very similar situations, you're fighting demons within yourself, and it's something that you need to come to terms with, like you said, like, bring attention to it in order to fix it. You're not going to be able to get a solution if you don't even know what your problem is. And address your problem. Know that you have a problem.
On a higher note, though, there's an awakening that's happening. I don't know if y'all can feel it or see it, but there's so many people who are starting to embrace what's going on, especially in this room, and embrace what happened to them and say, okay, this did happen to me, but I have a choice. I can choose to do something else, and the first thing I'm going to do is say something about it. The first thing. I'm gonna speak about it. Like, I'm gonna grab that power and I'm gonna hold on to that. Even if that's the only power that you have at the moment, that's what you've got. And then from that power, you can build on that power. Your power can become greater. Your power is already great. It's within you, but it's a light that's been dimmed. And so until we open up, we cannot let that light out. We gotta open up. And this is like this, events like this are what's gonna happen. What's gonna help us to open up like that?
Say that I really appreciate y'all sharing, because you said something. You said, you know, most of us in here have been violated, or we all been violated. And as a young man, that was never my concern. I had other concerns, but it does happen to men, but just not as much. And I'm in awe as how much it actually happens. Mm-hmm. You know,
it happens just as much. It's just not reported.
Actually,
as a man, would you feel comfortable with going to someone and saying, I have been molested, whether that's by an older woman, an older man, you know, a cousin, your dad, like, would you feel comfortable?
At this point, yes. But
I couldn't
speak up when I was a teenager, but that wasn't even a concern. Mm-hmm. I see how many women, that is a concern. That's something you have to be aware of. So that my daughter's wife, I have a daughter now, and you know, I couldn't even fathom having, you know, I was in the military, so I'm already crazy. But it's...
We're not crazy. You missed that part.
No, I was here. Oh. Crazy is whatever you're supposed to say. We're all crazy.
Yeah.
So,
that's what my ass.
But people know what I'm talking about. I feel my daughter protected, but that's not even... Listening to you all, that wasn't even a major concern. You know, it's basketball scholarships, it's all these other things. It wasn't, oh... Can she play my her uncle? Or, you know, is that game more than a game? Because a young boy, that wasn't my concerns. We talk about white privilege, but there's a freedom that I've had, you know, that I, you know, even growing up, I was able to be at an older person's house playing video games at the age of 14, 15, 16. And my mother asked, is something going on? I was like, no, I was thinking he just played video games, or a grown man that played video games. It seems normal. But young girls can't do that. Mm-hmm. Young girls couldn't put themselves in that situation because the high chance that there's some kind of predator out there is crazy. Mm-hmm. That's why I do appreciate y'all sharing, because, you know, and I looked around, there's not just males in here. Mm-hmm. And but, you know, and I don't know how often we get, listen, I'm not going to voice them up, you know, I have these concerns.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's not something I hear. So to hear it, and half the woman's already said it, so I don't know the other half, but it's safe to assume that it's a similar story.
Mm-hmm.
And I do appreciate you sharing it. It's, I'm gaining something from it, and it's giving me some perspective.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, we do have 15 minutes. I apologize, guys, but I do want you guys to have the space to share. So who wants the mic, Maple Leaf mic? You do have a mic. I feel like this is more intimate. Thank you for sharing, you guys. Thank you.
Intense emotional displays fight to keep themselves behind bars only to see through. Sometimes interpreted as shadows, what can't be denied is that they're just extensions of me and you. I'm introverted. Can anybody else hear my silent thoughts? Body language screams through these scenes and it seems that no one sees. That's because I fade to the backdrop. Extroverts looking like the haves and me the have-nots. Mental physicist, linguistic specialist, and lyricist. I can create mental double entendres for a display, but they're tripping inside of me. Every response creating ripples, helping me see. Pathfinder and trailblazer, preventive maintenance instead of controlled chaos. They follow the paths of their gods. Now please understand, don't forget the line about entendres. A god is anything that you worship or idolize, and more specifically, I was talking about more men. Or anything that is a byproduct of one, because maybe we can never understand God. Some say it's the sun, but why is it moving away from his creation? Some say it's the black queens, but most of us can't even begin to understand women. Some say Allah, Buddha, Jesus Christ, or something from that. Either way, what's important is the way the teachings of which we forget. It's a disconnect from us to the stars, and we whirl with gravity to master the space. Back to the topic though, just some inner thoughts I felt I could confess. So let's progress as I digress. I said I'm introverted. I thrive in solitude, and some think it's rude, but it's really misconstrued because of your perception of the world. You as an extrovert, you expect everyone to be like you. The facade of introverts are masked in confinement. I guess you could call us Bruce Wayne. Mortal man, knowledge of self, success-oriented, introspective, driven without match due to the effort unseen. Isn't it crazy that a superhero catches our persona and doesn't sweat it, but is always pushed to be seen? Everybody loves a mystery, and most of us are confined Pandora's boxes. Despite the hell we contain, we maintain perceptive peace, mastering will. When the skill needs to cool down, the box closes and is absorbed under layers of earth, and I mean our skin, and then it's like we're diamond skin holding light. And you can call me a freedom fighter, fighting into the things I write. Introverted in flesh and extroverted in wordplay. I oftentimes mention duality, but look at how perceptive too, but look at how perception to my poetry. See how my words play? Engaging you in every bar, every depth to be dissected. I expressed in some lines before about the depths of the depths the meanings are left with. Sorry. on this paper, or in this phone, my mind runs too wild to be confined to paper, much as I roam. Right here, I'm home. I live in my zone. This is how I get my recharge. Charged with the same offenses mentally, failing to realize these words, I'm in charge. Oftentimes, I fall back and catch fouls, subsequently crowd dive and think it's time to reward. Draining my infinite source, infinity in creativity, so it's still never ending, of course. Thick with words, can't be plastic to comb through this. But y'all didn't know introverts had swag like this. A little brag, then I switch. Hair shy and nervous tray behind the mic. Conserving energy and suffocating spontaneity, trying to keep this super suit intact. Identity is only revealed once the projection cracks. My projection, though, being an immovable object, only if I let you around can you begin to understand how the landmark was founded. I am the Plymouth Rock that avoided people to hit the ground. I got landed on and fell, so I'm in the system now. So now that I'm accounted for, let the games begin. I'm introverted while you're playing tag. The test is to see if I can get that.
Shout out to all the introverts. Anybody else want to come up to the mic?
I got a little piece for you. I was going to do a piece on mental health, but I can't find it in my phone, so I just want to talk about my blackness. I'm going to sit in this black chair. So my name is Dr. TV. I do poetry. I want to try something real quick. If I say one mic, can y'all say one mic? One mic.
One mic.
One mic.
One mic.
One mic.
One mic.
Thank you. What it means is respect the stage, respect the artists, you know, all that jazz.
She do this for her lifetime.
Yeah, I'll be doing poetry. I'm nervous because I always get nervous. Before I start, though, I want to plug a couple events I got coming up. So every Tuesday, I host a spoken word over mic. It's at Ridiculously Fit, the gym in Frankfurt. It's like $5 to get in before 8. And then anything after 8 is like $8. It's poetry based, but I'm trying to step outside of that and get people to just, whatever you want to do, you want to tap dance, you want to crip walk, come out, it's poetry. Because I be out here tap dancing. So I'm selling tickets for like $5, and it's valid for any Tuesday. Whenever you're ready to come through, check it out. I'm going to be your host. So this is called My Pride. I'm so nervous, you guys.
You got this, you got this.
Thank you. My pride be fried chicken and watermelon black. My pride be I can't come, so I'm telling black. My pride be callous fingers and blistered backs. My pride be loud. My pride be boastful. My pride be afros and chokers, summertime stunting and booty shorts and bandos. My pride be prepping while traveling out the band, though. Me goes the chance, though. Freedom at last, ho. My pride be Enoch. My pride be family, because we all that we got. My pride be... Damn, I forgot that name. That's quick. Can I hear a couple snaps? My pride be Enoch. My pride be family, because we all that we got. My pride be set tripping and crip walking. My pride be check spinning and slick talking. My pride be neck rolling and slick talking. Fake gold just to fit in. My pride be family. My pride be black. My pride be Kaepernick ready to smack a chick because the NFL ain't passing it. I mean, they won't catch the hint that we ain't backing down for ish. Yeah, my pride be a black ass fist. But my pride be loud. My pride be boastful. My pride be afros and chokers, summertime stunting and booty shorts and bandos. My pride be wrapping up, trapping out the bandos. Negos and chance, man. My pride. I got the tickets on sale, $5.
Feel free to, you guys, if you do have an event or something coming up, you can put it on that white paper in the back. There are markers, and that way I can share it on Instagram afterwards.
So, hi everyone, my name is Ivy. I'm Dave. I
I just have a piece that I wrote like 2 years ago. I never shared it in front of an audience before, but I wrote it. I was going through some things. All right, y'all can just listen to it. Tell me what y'all think. My mind been kind of hazy, thoughts be running like my nose. I just want someone to tell me they need me when they don't. Communication skills when ghost is clouds around my vision. I feel like I'm dreaming, fist when flying like a pigeon with the fingers through my hair and all the tapping on my toes. I'm breathing kind of heavy and the list goes on with those side effects of who knows what, because I'm undiagnosed. I pretend nothing affects on the inside, I'm a mess, but the OCD keeps it perfect though. I dare you to take a peek through these curtains, yo. Can't let anxiety get the best of me, because I want what's best for me. I'm hiding behind unknowns while the depression goes full blown. Damn, I think we got a problem. Ain't nothing home when you look inside of. Damn, you know you got a problem. And your brain is filled with unused knowledge. Thank you.
Mm. I love it.
Thank you, I appreciate it.
Would you be going at a morning restaurant?
So I do open mic events there. I try to do once a month. I think about switching the location to Studio 34.
Please.
Okay. So it's usually $5 to get in, bring your own bottle, and yeah, just if y'all want to follow me on Instagram, you stay in touch with the events and everything like that. My name is AIZHYY with 2 underscores.
You can put your Instagram up on the page too if you want to. I really quick would like to get a picture with everybody if that's possible.
That is possible.
Oh, before you do that, research is on social media and also the 24th of March.
All right, so I'm Exhibit A. You can follow me on Instagram, Exhibit A Art Design. If you're not already, I'll make sure that all of you are. But we are having another event in the bigger space upstairs, which I would like to invite all of you back out to. And it will be on the weekend too, so we can all go to work tomorrow and be okay. But I would like to invite you to share once again, bring your submissions. You can shoot me an email, exhibitartdesign@gmail.com, or shoot me a DM on Instagram. But I would love for everybody to come back out, share your story. I love the space that we made here and just everybody expressing themselves and being able to give feedback, you know, to other people, because sometimes it's easier to hear it from somebody else. Sometimes it's easier to hear it from your peers. And sometimes it's people that you wouldn't normally talk to. So getting that feedback is beneficial. Thank you so much, POC. How many of you guys in the back? If you guys did not get a massage, I don't know why you didn't, but get her Instagram information, Harmony the Goddess, so that you can get your own personalized healing consultation there. And I invite everybody once again to write down their Instagram so that we can all stay connected. March 24th is the next date when we will be here upstairs in the bigger room. Thank you guys all again for coming out. I appreciate all your support. Make sure you take a button. Stunt your button. Okay, hashtag. Oh, I'm sorry, Crystal Alchemy as well. I'm so sorry. You can follow them at Crystal Alchemy. I don't know how to spell that, but what she said. They are also on Instagram. Please check out their wonderful jewelry before you head out.
Y'all also cater too, though, right?
Yes, vegan spice.
You're good at doing it, yes.
To train people on natural movement and yoga.
sure they can get a printout of it. I have the smaller 4x6 as well as 8x10 frames as well. Photography, I'm also a photographer. If you guys need photography for your event, product information, I mean product shots, I do that as well.
So you popping popping
this. Trying to do all of this. Make sure that you take one of my stickers, take a few of them, stick them places, share the information.
Why you should be the street team now.
Yeah. Newcomer didn't know we got one to know. You've now been recruited.
And please make sure that you tune into Revive Radio on the radio. How many days a week?
Seven shows. Everything, what we're doing here, collective consciousness, really, everything from trending topics, current events, local news. I'm a really big politics buff, so I talk about politics as well. Ownership, I have two business consultants who come in and we do Money Talk Mondays, where we talk about becoming the employer instead of the employees.
Oh, and that's on Monday?
Yeah, on Monday. Different days of that.
What's your Instagram?
@Revive_POC. Yes, I can actually hand you guys some flyers. She has some stickers that we're going to pass out to you guys as well. So thank you once again for coming through. Also, with the sign-in sheet that you guys signed in, we're also going to be starting a newsletter with this and some email blasts so you can actually start, you know, to hear more about it and share more information too so you know what is coming. And thank you for creating the safe space,
yes.
You know what I mean? Like, it's about the energy that actually comes into the space that makes it safe, you know what I mean? So I appreciate everyone coming in here with the open mind, you know, open heart, as well as, you know, no judgment. So we definitely appreciate you guys coming through. Thank you. Appreciate your time.
You.
And all the love donations as well. Thank
you. Yes, thank you. One last thing, when you go out, I do graphics, but this graphic in particular, if you guys are interested in getting your medical cannabis card, we have events coming up. So not only do you get information about getting your card, but and it's through mental health. So it's all ties together. We do fun stuff. Like, y'all missed out on sushi making last week. It was so dope. Like,
I didn't even hear about that, no.
Because you're not following Revive.
No, I need them on Instagram.
Turn on the notifications.
But thank you for that. But yeah, so more information about that too, because we're trying to bridge the gap between entrepreneurs, you know what I mean, small businesses, and then also artists as well, because there are a lot of different things that people may shy away from when it comes to cannabis, but it actually has some benefits in it. And you don't always have to consume the THC, which is, you know, the thing that gets you high, or the cannabinoid, that's not a thing, but the cannabinoid that gets you high. There are other, you know, different parts of the cannabis plant that can actually help you and benefit from you. You can benefit from it. So, yes, I would encourage you to definitely check it out. It's every other month on a Sunday. Every other month on a Sunday. Yeah.
Yes. Thank you guys again for coming. Please take food. Thank you guys for coming.
Right?
Yeah, oh, the picture. Okay.
Healthcare. We're going to be surprisingly easy to fit in a little moment just for you. wind down with a healthy skincare ritual that includes Burt's Bees, sensitive facial cleansing, night and facial massage. End the day your way with Burt's Bees sensitive skincare and be a true force of nature tomorrow.
Yeah. somewhere.
Yeah.